something softly. Why? God said, if you don't keep my commandments and do things the way I've asked you to do, and do things rightly, none of the diseases will come upon you. But if you don't do it, you are going to be cursed, and those diseases will come upon you. So these people are living in suffering, in shame, in distress. They will often be sent to captivity. And now, they were wondering, how would this law be fulfilled? They were living with a yoke on their neck. And Jesus came. They thought that Jesus would come and say, oh, yes, the things will be taken away just like that. He said, no, all of this thing must be fulfilled. And I'm sure they looked at Jesus and said, it means you instead, truly, you are not the Messiah. Hallelujah. I thought you came to save us. And now you are coming to make us get to make the load that's already on us very heavy. They did not know that the very person they were talking to is the one that was going to fulfill all that law. Hallelujah. And now it so happened. Let's go to Acts. Acts chapter 3. God so loved the world that he gave us his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him shall never die and have everlasting life. Are we in Acts chapter 3? Verse 18. Okay, can we all read? One, two, go. But those things which God before had showed by the mouth of all his prophets that Christ should suffer. Hallelujah. Now, when Jesus came, he had to. He was a savior when he came. So, he had to fulfill the law for us so that we will not have to fulfill the law, to follow the law the same way God gave them before we benefit from the benefits of the laws that were given. Hallelujah. So in this verse, the Bible is telling us the apostles were giving testimony that Jesus has already fulfilled those commandments. Praise the Lord. Are you here? Tell your neighbor, say in him. Ask the neighbor, are you in him? So we're heading somewhere. Okay. Thank you. 1 Corinthians. We get to 1 Corinthians. You hold on there and you go to 1 John. We're going to come back to 1 Corinthians after 1 John. Go to it so fast. 1 John chapter 3 verse 8. Just go ahead. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Okay, can we all read? One, two, go. Wait. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Can we all read? One, two, go. Okay. Hallelujah. We established that sin came into the world because of the devil's deception for people to go against God. Hallelujah. And now the Bible is telling us in 1 John chapter 3, that the second part of it, he says that for this very purpose, the Son of God was manifested that he might do what? That he might do what? We agree that sin brought sickness and suffering upon the world. Amen. And now, if for that purpose Jesus came, so that he might destroy the works of the devil, did he succeed to destroy the works of the devil?
Yes.
What does that mean? Tell your neighbor the answer. What does that mean? I want you to listen to the scriptures. If Jesus came to destroy the works of the devil, and now he finally succeeded to destroy the work of the devil, and one of the works of the devil is that he caused sicknesses, he caused pain, and suffering, what does that mean? Do you know why Jesus was never sick? Did you ever read anywhere the Bible say Jesus was sick?
No.
That he was crying of poverty or something? Why? He lived without sin. Are we understanding? Many times the devil came to put affliction on him or do anything that has to go against the comfort of his life. But he did not see any means to get to him. Why? There was no sin. Hallelujah. Amen. And because he lived, because of the promises we read in Exodus. So he lived and fulfilled the will of God throughout his life. So there was no way sickness or suffering could come upon him. Are we understanding? We are going to unveil something about a Christian. That's why we are talking about in him. Hallelujah. We are talking about in him. So it came to this point. John was telling us, he said, brethren, you have to understand this thing. This John that we are talking about, this was a man when he had understood what Christ had done for him. The Bible says persecution rose up at that time and they caught him and put him in boiling oil and he came out alive. Because he had understood what Christ had done for him. And that is what I want to share with us today. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So that we can have an understanding of who we are. The greatest problem that Christians have is because we don't understand who we are. That's why the devil comes to afflict us. Meanwhile, Jesus has paid the price on the cross for us. If only you realize what he has done. You will not need to go through the things again. When you're going through something that Jesus has paid for, it's as if you're crucifying him again on the cross. The second time. Hallelujah. So at this point, John is telling us, he said that this is the purpose for which the Son of Man came, that he might destroy the works of the devil. Let's go to Hebrews chapter 2. We'll see one part of the works which he destroyed right there. Hebrews chapter 2 verse 14. You dare say I'm there. Amen. Only the choir is saying I'm there. You dare say I'm there.
Amen.
Glory. Amen. Wow. We thank God for the prayer that the man of God prayed on Friday. Now the sun is shining. How many of us are here in the service? Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And was declared that today there will be good weather. Thank God for good weather.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Okay. Are you in chapter 2 of Hebrews? 1, 2, go, verse 14. For as much then as children are partakers of the flesh and blood, he also himself likewise took part of the same, that through death he might destroy him. Has Jesus died? No, he has died and he is alive. That's why he said, amen. When he appeared to John in Revelation, he said, I am he that was dead and now I'm alive forever. The Bible is telling us here, he said, because we, that is humans, were partakers of flesh and blood, he himself as Jesus came also, to take part just like us, to become humans just like us, so that he might help to destroy the one that was oppressing us, as us. Are we understanding? Jesus came and took our place. So that we, whatever he does against the Satan, it will be as if we are the one that have done it. That is what this verse is saying. Amen. Let's read verse 15. You will see what he did there. Verse 15, want to go. He said he destroyed the one that had the power of death. That is the devil. Devil had the power of death, but the Bible says Jesus defeated him. He defeated, Satan had the power to cause affliction on men. But Jesus defeated him so that he might deliver us. We were all our lifetime subject to bondage. We were afraid that Satan would kill us. We were afraid that if we go out there, Satan will do something. We are afraid that when we enter a bus, we'll have accident. You are afraid that maybe when you save money, thieves will come and steal it. But the Bible is saying that Jesus destroyed him that had the power of death. So that we were afraid of those things that Satan would do against us, will be delivered from it.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
This is the meaning of the gospel. It is good news. It means there was something that was pressing us down. But the good news is that somebody came and lifted it up for us.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. So when we are talking of the gospel of Jesus, Jesus Christ. It is not to put us in bondage. That's why we must be excited to be Christians. Hallelujah. You must be excited that you have received this gospel into you. Because the day you give your heart to Christ, you receive deliverance. Hallelujah. You receive deliverance from that very first day. Praise the Lord. Let's go to Colossians. Are we in Colossians?
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yes,
say, I'm free.
I am free.
Say, I'm free.
I am free.
I've been delivered.
I am delivered.
From every oppression. Hallelujah.
Yes,
I refuse to be oppressed.
I refuse to be
oppressed. No more nightmares.
No more nightmares.
When I sleep, I sleep in peace.
When I sleep
in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Paradigo Sata. Okay, Colossians chapter 3, start reading from verse 1. 1 to 3. He said, you are dead. Amen. Understand this verse 3. He said, you are dead and your life is hid with Christ in God. Wait, you are dead. Are you dead? Are you dead? Okay, how many of us agree that we are dead? How many of us agree that we are dead? Please let me see your hand. Hallelujah. Based on our message, right?
Yeah.
We are dead. Amen. Based on our message. Why? Because somebody died for us.
Yes,
are you understanding?
Yes.
The day Jesus died, you died. The day he was buried, you were buried. The day he rose from the dead, you were raised with a new life. That is why he said, any man be in Christ. He is a new creature. Why? You died long ago, and now you have been raised as a new man in him.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Say, I'm alive. Your life is in two faces. Hallelujah. When you meet a situation, that situation is either talking about your present life or your past life.
Yes.
Amen.
Yeah.
If it is something that is not consistent with the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ, it's about your past life. It is something glorious, something nice, something good, it's about your present life in Christ.
Yeah.
Do you understand? What does that mean? It means when I face a bullet, I am dead to that bullet.
Yeah.
Can a bullet kill a dead man?
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Afraid of anything.
Yes.
No wonder David said, they know not in Psalm 82, neither will they understand. The world has gone out of course. He said, but I have said, you are God, and all of you are children of the Most High. He said, but in ignorance they will die like men and fall like one of the princes. I refuse to be ignorant. I live as a God in this life. And whatever comes against me, I stand against it in the name of Jesus. And there is no way I'm going to be challenged. Hallelujah.
Jesus Christ,
that though he was poor, for our sake he became rich, that us through his poverty Christ.
In Christ.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Thank you, sweet. Thank you. We are sharing verse 3. We are seeing verse 3. Amen. Verse 3. He said, for ye are dead. How many of us are dead? I'm sure most of us now are accepting. How many of us are dead? Hallelujah. I'm dead.